Hi, I'm Mr. Beats. I'm one of the subject matter experts here at Chegg. When it comes to understanding the design of the tax system, you might have a few questions. But don't worry, we can help you understand taxes and equity in no time. Taxes in the United States generally serve three purposes. Number one, to ensure societal necessities are maintained. Number two, to promote equity in society. And number three, to limit negative externalities. You'll find, however, that these reasons often go hand in hand. First, let's talk about negative externalities. Negative externalities are something bad that happens when a consumer purchases a particular good. An example of this would be cigarettes, which emit pollution. Pollution would be the negative externality. Taxes are often used to prevent people from overspending on goods that may be detrimental, such as alcohol or cigarettes. These are often referred to as sin taxes. Next, let's talk about using taxes to keep societal goods well maintained. Taxes frequently go toward goods and services used by everyone, like police, schools, and more. There is a belief in the United States that everyone deserves access to basic things like education and safety. Even though we know everyone deserves these things, it can be hard to distribute taxes fairly. Some schools, roads, and common goods in certain areas receive less tax funding, which makes them difficult to maintain. However, even in lower income areas, you will still find all of these services, which will be paid for by taxes. The government and economists are constantly evaluating how to make sure taxes are distributed fairly. Providing necessary public goods also goes hand in hand with creating equity, another common goal in taxation. The government requires those with higher incomes to pay more in taxes, making our tax system progressive and more equitable. Our tax system is designed this way so that those with lower incomes are still left with much of their income to go towards basic necessities. Let's explore how this system works. As stated, the U.S. tax system is progressive, which means that the higher someone's income is, the more taxes they pay. Some other countries use regressive tax systems where you pay more in taxes when you have less income, but we'll cover that more later. The United States uses a progressive tax system because the government wants everyone to be able to afford basic necessities like food and health care. Consider someone who is making $30,000 a year. For this person, the vast majority of their income will go toward their basic necessities. Now consider someone who makes $500,000 a year. For this person, some of their income will still go towards their basic necessities. However, a large part will go to non-necessities, like vacations, a summer home, or other luxury goods. The amount someone will spend on luxuries and basic goods is determined by their marginal propensity to consume. This theory posits that as someone's income increases, they will spend more money on goods and services. The government understands that those with lower income may be more reliant on the money they have to afford their basic necessities, while someone who earns significantly more will be able to afford basic necessities, luxury goods, and higher taxes. The government's focus on equity is designed to make sure everyone gets what they need while still supporting societal and communal goods. In this way, taxes help support the redistribution of wealth and income, as those with the most money have taxes that wind up supporting others. For instance, when taxes go towards funding a school, the school then supports jobs, which improves the economy for everyone. There are many debates over the tax system. For one, while the tax system is overall progressive, some aspects are regressive. Regressive taxes are the ones that tend to hit those with lower incomes harder than those with higher incomes. For instance, gross receipts taxes are taxes that are applied to a company's gross sales. This means the tax is applied to all of the money a company earns without subtracting their costs or expenses. Because these taxes don't take into account expenses, it tends to hit startup or struggling businesses, which are usually run by middle-class individuals, harder. This is just one example of when taxes negatively affect lower or middle-income individuals more than wealthier ones. There are also loopholes that large companies or extremely wealthy individuals take advantage of. The tax system is complex, which can make it difficult for the government to figure out that someone is not paying the correct amount of taxes. Tax evasion prevents the system from being as equitable as it could be. Thus, some believe that taxes are not doing enough to create more equality in society. Many argue that large corporations and wealthy individuals should be taxed more. Conversely, some individuals believe that taxes are already too high. People in these groups think that tax money is misallocated. Others simply do not wish for their taxes to be as high as they are. Taxes vary widely across the United States, with each state having their own unique rules. As politicians and economists continue determining the best way to tax individuals and businesses, we'll continue to see debates over equity. We hope you enjoyed this video on taxes and equity. Come visit us at Chegg whenever you want help from our subject matter experts.